Kia ora anō, nau mai haere mai ki te pāheke me te whakatika o te pūtere o Mangamuka. Once again, I'm Kylie Harris, here to talk you through our July flyover. He tino harikoa hau ki te whakapua ki I tēnei kōrero kia koutou katoa. We're starting at the northernmost slip. This has been named A47 and is the newest slip from the weather event in June 2024. It's approximately 20 metres long and 3 metres deep from the edge of the road. As you can see, the movement has pushed the debris down to the river. The three patches on the carriageway are cone penetration tests, also known as CPT, for investigation and analysis. These tests are carried out by our geotechnical engineers and they test the strength of the ground around the slip. The design for this wall is still being developed and works will be carried out over the coming months. Next is combined slips A1 and A2. The cages are being delivered to the site and will be used to reinforce the pile it will be placed into after splicing the two cages together. With the northern section of piles now complete, you can see the coring of the anchors have begun. This means we're progressing smoothly. This preparation is crucial for the stability and strength of the structure and helps with transitioning into capping beam works. Next up is slip A3. As you can see, we're currently installing the guardrails. Guardrails are barriers installed along the sides of roads and highways, designed to prevent vehicles from veering off the road, especially in hazardous areas. They play a vital role in enhancing road safety by absorbing the impact of collisions and reducing the severity of accidents. We're now flying over slip A4. Here at the northern end, you can see some finished piles. The LB24 drill rig is set up to drill permanent pile 25. This pile is the deepest pile so far and is 32.8 metres from the top of the casing. Next, our centre bogan crane is set up and waiting for the cages to arrive, which will be placed into the drilled pile. Behind that, you can see the tremi rack, which will assist with the concrete pour. Directly to the right of the tremi rack, you can see the machine that is coring the anchors. This is slip A5. The capping beam is now complete and the anchor slots have been filled. The only tasks remaining to officially finish this slip site are installing the guardrails and completing the road reinstatement. We're continuing on to slip A6. We've completed the piling aspects and 2/3 of the capping beam is finished. The northern end of the capping beam looks a little bit different from the rest of the beam because it doesn't require anchors in that section. Here you can see the last section being inspected before we begin pouring concrete to finish this capping beam off. This is slip A7. Notice the hole covers to the right? They are the locations of the piles for this site and have all been cored and are ready for drilling. Piling works for this slip will commence once the drainage crew finishes installing the culvert at the southern end, as shown. Slip A8 has undergone significant changes since our last update. We're currently drilling test piles and the bored drains are being installed just a few metres down behind the trees to the right of this shot. We're now flying over slip A9, where significant progress has been made. All the permanent piles in the capping beam works are complete. Currently, the anchors are being installed, which will tie the beam back into the maunga, ensuring stability and strength for the structure. This is a crucial phase in reinforcing the area and preventing future slips. The piling aspect of slip A26 has been successfully completed, as you can see. Now we are in the process of installing concrete panels at the southern end of the slip. The concrete panels will provide additional support and protection against future erosion or movement, marking another significant step towards the project's completion. This is slip A10. At this slip site, we'll be upgrading the drainage in the slip-prone area and rebuilding the roading layer works, where the road has subsided, and reinstate the road surface. Just under 28,000 cubic metres have been cut and removed from slip A11. The area has experienced movement during the winter months, and we will continue to monitor it closely. Currently, a rock spall wall is being installed, which will act as a barrier while we upgrade existing drainage assets and install new ones. Following this, we will proceed with creating the new road. The final repairs will be completed after winter, with plans in place to ensure the road will be ready to open by Christmas time this year. We're now flying over three different slips, A12, A13 and A27. With A27 complete, the anchor installation on A12 is tracking well. Anchors provide additional support, help distribute loads more evenly, reducing the risk of structural failure, and can extend the lifespan of the structure, ensuring long-term performance. Slip A13's capping beam is now complete. Once the anchors have been installed on neighbouring site A12, the team will move here to install the anchors for this slip site. And that concludes this flyover update. Ngā mihi nui ki a koutou katoa mō tō manawa nui, me tō tautoko mō ngā tangata katoa, e mahi ana I konei mō te kaupapa, Mangamuka.